Okay, hi everyone, welcome back to another video. Today's video is a figure review on the AMC's The Walking Dead Series 10 Walgreens exclusive Sasha figure. This figure is a part of the 5-inch wave, and she is the newest character right now. I think there's a Jesus coming out. But she is the last female character that was made for the show. She's not the last female character, but she was the last one made. And I got her in yesterday, and I thought I would review her for you guys today. My goal with Walking Dead figures is I wanted to get at least one of every character that McFarlane makes. Walkers, I could live without, but characters... I wanted one of each character, and I'm pretty sure I have all the figures that McFarlane has made. Not all of them, but all the characters that McFarlane has made so far. I'm really hoping that Lori gets made. I don't know why you won't make her. She would sell good, but that's another story. See, if it was up to me, I would make all the characters. That's just me, though. Let's go ahead and take a look at the packaging. At the top here, we have AMC, oopsie, backdrop fell. Anyways, up at the top here, we have AMC's The Walking Dead, McFarlane Toys logo, Series 10, Sasha name, exclusive, based on the hit AMC TV series. On the back is, more exclusive figures you can get, Constable Rick or Aaron. I do have Aaron. Kind of want to get Rick, but then if I get him, I'm going to have to get Mijon too. And then the 10-inch Glenn and some of the 7-inch figures. Another McFarlane Toys logo and an address if you want to write him or something. And other information down below. And that's really it. So what I'm going to do is take a minute and get Sasha out of the box. Okay, and we are back with Sasha out of the box, and I gotta say, this is a pretty nice figure, but let's go ahead and get into the articulation. She has a ball-jointed head, bowing shoulders, hinged elbows, hinged wrist. You want to be careful with these hinged wrists because they can break, hinged hips, hinged knees, and a swivel at the ankle. So this is Sasha. This character first appeared in season 3 with her brother Tyrese and some other characters, and to be honest, I like Sasha. She wasn't my favorite character, but I did like her, and to be honest, she was one of those characters I thought that wasn't going to be in the show long. Sonequa Markin Green plays her, and she also played Tamara in Once Upon a Time, which I did not like her character in Once Upon a Time, but I think this is in the outfit Sasha wears in the season 6/7 premiere, season 6 finale, when they first meet Negan, and he makes them all line up, and he pretty much decides who he is going to kill. And I think that's the outfit. I could be wrong though. But the figure is nicely done. She has a purplish shirt on, a sweater on, and it's nicely textured and detailed. She has some straps here for an accessory, which I will show you in a minute. She has a blue jeans on, with a couple holsters for her weapon there. On her hands, she has a fingerless glove. And then I can't tell if these are the socks or just a part of the pants, but they are black, whatever they are. And then you can see she has brown boots on. And then the back is nicely done as well. And then you can see her hair is really nicely sculpted to how she wore it in the show most of the time. When she first appeared, she had a couple different hairstyles. And then the face sculpt, I think, is probably one of the best Walking Dead face sculpts I've ever seen. It looks just like Sonequa Martin Green, who plays her. And I think sometimes McFarlane gets them good and it does look like them, and then other times McFarlane just doesn't get it doesn't get it at all, but this is an A plus, looks just like her. And I know they use the 3D scan for people, but I mean, this looks like she just popped out of the show, to be honest. And it's really nice face sculpt. Her accessories, now she comes with this little bag, a pouch bag, and you nicely sculpted, painted as well. All you do is you just hook it on there. Not really sure why they went with that. Not sure why they just didn't, you know, put it on her in the first place. And it doesn't fall off, and it stays on. So, she comes with a knife. A very nicely done knife. It's not too, sometimes these knives can be, you know, breakable, too flimsy, but this one is nice and sturdy. And she can either hold it in her hand, like so, or you can take it out and put it in her holster. Like, hold up. I think I'm doing this the right way. Okay. There we are. Like so, which I will probably leave it in there just so it doesn't get lost. And then, oops, this piece of tape. She comes with a pretty thick looking pistol, which is pretty cool. Just kind of, we've seen these before. And you can, her hands are pretty small, so you're gonna wanna be careful. You wanna pry them open a little. Sometimes with these female Walking Dead characters, they have very small hands. So it's hard to get weapons in there. But there she is with the pistol, which she has used a couple times in the show. Spoiler alert, if you're not caught up with season 7, she was unfortunately one of the unlucky characters in season 7, and she is no longer on the show, which that's very sad. I like Sasha. Or you can take her gun, pistol, and you can put it in the holster. Kind of gotta get, push it in there. And sometimes these straps don't always work, but kind of some. Again, that's probably where I will be leaving mine. And then we have her signature rifle that she used, at least in season 7 and I think season 6. Very nicely sculpted and painted. I like the silver part right there. And you can either strap it on her, which I like the option. Or you can take it and you can hopefully hold it, because she does have a very big, okay. So that's pretty cool. Let's see if we can. Yeah, it's a very big gun, so she's kind of a small figure, so it kind of makes her look very small with this big gun. But that's pretty much it on the figure. I like this figure. If I bring in, her brother, Tyrese, and this is all the way from Series 4, I believe, yeah, because he was in the same wave with Andrea. And I like them. They were both really cool characters. Tyrese died in season 5, but they look good together. There was another Tyrese too, from his death episode, but I do not have him, unfortunately. But there's Tyrese, and they look good together. And then if I bring in another character, if she'll stand up. So I bring in her boyfriend for a little bit, Bob. Wasn't a huge fan of Bob, he was okay, but they did end up together for a little bit, and they also look nice together, too. I know it was hard on her when she, when they both of them died. Okay, so here is Sasha with some of the, actually most of the Walking Dead women that have been made into the figure. All these are official McFarlane figures except for my custom Laura here. I don't know why they won't make her. It would be great if McFarlane could go back, make Lori, Jesse, Deanna, and would, now this is just being picky, but I would love a Sherry too, because I really liked Sherry last season. Jackie and Amy. See, if I was at McFarlane, all those characters would be made, because it finishes a collection, and I just really think, especially Lori, she was like Rick's wife, the main character. But anyway, Sasha does look good with them, and really glad to add them to my collection. I gotta say, I think Sasha, between Andrea and Sasha, they have the best face sculpts. Mijone is good too. Carol is okay. Maggie's is okay, and Beth is okay. But I think Andrea and Sasha look a lot like Lori Holden and Sonequa Martin Green. So that's going to do it for this video. Let me know what you think of Sasha here. If you have her, do you collect any of the other Walking Dead figures? Do you collect the humans? Do you collect the zombies? Do you collect both? Let me know. Do you like Sasha? What did you think of her as a character? Let me know all that down in the comments below. Alright, all my information, as always, is down below. Please subscribe to my channel and have a great day. Bye. Okay, you guys made it to the end of the video. Thank you for watching. I hope you guys enjoyed the video. Remember, you guys can follow me on the social media links I have in my channel and down below. And I also do have a fan mail address. If you would like to send fan mail, feel free to do so. And I hope you guys enjoyed this review. Please subscribe to my channel and have a great day. Bye.